Hi, welcome again. So today I'm just going to show you this dashboard and help you understand what this dashboard is all about in Azure Sentinel. So if you have configured just now, you may not have the same dashboard. So there's a little stuff you may need to do, because the data is going to be shown here is based on the configuration you may have. For example, you have to set up the Sentinel to collect the data from different sources, and based on that is going to be displayed here on the dashboard. So if you look at total alerts are there, but these alerts are coming from these activities, for example, or the signing logs, right? I can easily ingest the signing logs because of my Azure AD tenant. And if there are any suspicious activities, it will generate the alerts based on the machine learning and machine teaching and AI and the way you have set it up. On top of that, you can see also office activities, something I have set it up. And if you want to learn more, you can watch my other videos where how you can set up the data connector and ingest the log. So that's what it is all about. That is it has activity from Microsoft 365 tenant and collecting the logs from there. Signing logs, again, I just told you about from the Azure AD itself. When people sign in, these are the logs that are here, and all these alerts, 117 alerts. I mean, and then you have to go and take a look on these alerts manually. Some of the stuff you can also automate it depending. So if when I hover, it tells me that, you know, there are two alerts and it's based on those 77 activities, you know, and nothing shows on signing logs, so maybe something else. If I come here, these are, as you can see here, it says, okay, it has something to do with the signing logs. So I would want to go and check what's going on. It has gone down. So if you go back and forth and want to look at the alert itself, the chart is real time, will give you the data accordingly, right? Potential malicious event, I don't see here anything. Nothing has been found, because with this graph or the map is very useful, especially if you want to look for some outbound malicious activities happening in the environment. It will just show you right here. So this is very important. So nothing is there, which means something, you know, you still have to investigate, but there is no connection being made out, for example, from your tenant or services outside. One more thing I want to add here is it's based on 30 days, so you can do it last 24 hours. And why it is important, because the number of users you are supporting in this organization, for example, for me it's just one or two user, but if you have I've seen the environment as big as, you know, 5,000, 50,000, 100,000 environment. So this gets very complicated, and then you have to really tweak it and customize it, because too much data, you know, it's become real problem. So that's why another reason to change the timeline, and also based on the particular threat or something you wanted to check and investigate. Over here, if I go to, let's say, 30 days, I have different data available. If I go to 14 days, so it all goes back how far you want to go back for particular thing to trace or hunt. And as you can see on the right side, all these things, security incident happen, usage and everything. So if I can go and click here, you know, it will give you the more details around the security incident, and then you can leverage this and find out more. So we're just waiting for the data to be popped up here. Security incident happened on 23rd of August, and then what are those six count happens, and there on the left side you can also check some of this stuff here. So it's all, you have to start digging into that you'll have to start looking into that. You need to know a little bit of about Kutso language, the log management, the audit logs. This data is being pulled from Azure activity. There is some stuff related to sign-in logs. So basically, then you have to start digging into that and find, start hunting and chasing. So basically, that's how it's going to help you. And this is where the area you can apply these different data types here, different input. So basically, from this system onward, you need to learn about the Kutso language. And also, there is a chart, as you can see. And you can see which day you have more security incident versus less. So it all depends on the environment, because just example here, I hope this helped. Let me know what you think. And in the future videos, I'll be adding some more stuff there. So that's what we covered here today. The dashboard of this thing. And let me see if I can go back more than 30 days. Usually it should give you something along like 90 days, but let me see if I have this availability, this thing available in my environment. So we started from June to now. Yeah, so June to September, as you can see, now I am able to see for what, 5-6 months. So it does allow you up to 90 days, I believe. So you can do the math. It looks like pretty much that range, and you can see how many alerts have been happening. So it also help, let's say if you apply some policies and everything, so alert may go down. So it kind of give you, keep track which month alerts have been going up and down, and you can take the action based on that. I hope that helps, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you and bye.